This video was spurred on by a great suggestion by one of the commenters in a recent Hamada Shori video I made. They wanted me to compare the techniques of Hamada Shori and Katsuhiko Kashiwazaki. So we'll see another judo math equation in a moment, then I'll be back for some detailed technical breakdowns of their judo. Kashiwazaki and Hamada both began judo when they were 10 years old. Kashiwazaki won the world championship when he was 29 years old. In high school, Hamada often studied Kashiwazaki's world championship videos in her school's dojo for 1 hour before the school's 7:30 a.m. training session started. Hamada became world champion on her 28th birthday. She won Olympic gold when she was 30 years old and 10 months. Kashiwazaki started Sambo in his second year at university. After a year of training, he placed second in the European Championships. Hamada started Sambo in her fourth year at university. After a year of training, she won the 2013 World University Games. In 2014, she won the World Championship. If you're familiar with Hamada's judo, these Sambo pictures will come as no surprise. One thing to note is that in Sambo, you cannot use ude-garami as a submission, you can use it as a control. You can use ude-gatame. Let's talk technique. Let's look at a hand control that Kashiwazaki uses. Notice how he's flaring his wrist backwards to control the arm in ude-garami with just one arm. We're going to see Hamada Shori do the same thing here. I call this a reverse claw grip. If you know the correct judo terminology, please leave a comment. So let's look at this from the beginning. Hamada gets poked in the eye. If you watch the Paralympics blind judo, you'll see that as long as you have grips, eyesight is really not that important in judo. So Hamada is able to continue here. She gets an ude-garami. She starts to elevate her opponent. And her opponent tries to go behind. Does a version of a berimbolo. But Hamada Shori is able to escape her leg. Her opponent then tries to flip over her right shoulder. But because of the ude-garami, she's unable to complete the roll. And Hamada forces her to submit. So this reverse claw grip is used by a lot of players in judo. I've got a video with Chizuru Arai using this position. I'll leave a link to that. The next thing we're going to look at is how Kashiwazaki uses the judogi's hem to control this ude-garami position. So he pulls the hem very tightly, passing it to his hand, and this allows him to begin passing guard using the other hand. Now we'll see Hamada Shori win a match using this technique here. So it's going to start off with an attempted choke, so kosotogari into an okuri eri jime, and as she starts to slip out, Hamada takes control of the sleeve of the judoka in white, and she's going to look to establish an ude-garami, and then she reaches out, grabs the hem of the jacket, pulls it tightly, just like we saw Kashiwazaki do, Now she's able to begin passing guard using the left hand that was originally involved in the ude-garami, but can now be used for guard passing and to control this pin. I've got a video with Masako Doi showing two examples of using this type of grip to help with turnovers and pins. I'll leave a link to that in the description. Here's another example of Hamada Shori using the Judogi hem to get a victory. So opponent fails a turning throw due to the sleeve control of Hamada. Hamada sliding her knee under the opponent's body and controlling the belt. We'll see Kashiwazaki doing similar things during this video. Now she's looking to establish the ude-garami. The opponent's defending the arm very tightly. There's the judogi hem control. She now passes it to her hand. And she establishes the kamishiho gatame. Because of the tightness of the control, it's very difficult for this opponent to escape. Now let's see Kashiwazaki's great half guard passing in full. First we see Kashiwazaki looked to get the ude-garami and use this reverse claw grip while he passes the judogi hem to his right hand. Now he begins to look to pass the guard. Now the opponents manage to trap both of Kashiwazaki's legs. Now if Kashiwazaki didn't have that right hand control, his opponent would be able to move into some kind of rugby pass or marote grip position, but because of that arm control, Kashiwazaki's got lots of passing options, and he does this wonderful technique reaching under his opponent's wrist and putting the wrist in a weakened position and gripping his opponent's pants and kicking away to free the arm. And because he still has complete domination of his opponent's right arm, it's very easy for him to maintain this pinning position. One of the big differences between Kashiwazaki and Hamada is their relative leg length compared to their opponents. Kashiwazaki competed around the 63 kilo division. Classifications changed sort of throughout his career. Hamada competes in the under 78 kilo division. Most of the players are much taller for her. Having shorter legs is such a big advantage for passing half guard. So you can see here just how easily Hamada is able to slip out her leg. It's a lot easier for her to pass half guard. I do have a video on my channel showing Hamada having to pass half guard against a shorter legged opponent. I'll put a link to that in the description. She has a very special way of completing the guard pass that is seldom seen. Next we'll have a look at the Kashiwazaki turnover. So it's very similar to Hamada's. Notice how the knee's sliding under the body. He's using a belt grip to pull his opponent over. And he likes to go to this mount position where he maintains control of the belt, similar to what would be called a Georgian grip in Sambo. I think it's often referred to as a cross overhand grip in Judo. So this control is an extremely tight way to control the mount. And Hamada Shori also likes to do this. So I hadn't tried using this position until last week. Here's Hamada's sumigaeshi to the belt control, tate-shiho gatame position. So There's the sumigaeshi. She reaches over, grabs the belt, and the opponent is able to bridge, but she's not able to shift or off-balance Hamada. Hamada's able to keep a tight control, and there's no chance for her to escape the mount. While I was researching this video, I thought I really should give it a go to see what it feels like. And first I did it on a white belt, and after about 20 to 30 seconds, I was like, I just have to let this one go, because I can tell this guy has no chance of escape. Now we'll look at Hamada using an ude-garami turnover, and then mounting and holding the ude-garami. Very similar to the previous position where she was grabbing the belt. I did some ouchi komi with a black belt friend of mine, and I showed him this belt grip, tate-shiho gatame, and he said, yeah, it's really uncomfortable, and he saw no chance of escape. I think in the previous video I did on Hamada's guard, there was a tap to this belt control position, and I realize it's because of the discomfort. Now here's another example of the hikkomigaeshi used from the guard position. Here's Hamada's hikkomigaeshi. And here's another, starting from closed guard, Hamada reaching back. The opponent has strong control of Hamada's left hand, but still Hamada is able to use her leg hooks to flip her opponent. One of the great Yoko Tomoanages of all time, it comes from a leg grab situation. The opponent reaches for Kashiwazaki's leg as he goes for that kochi, and Kashiwazaki throws in this side jump. Because the opponent's reached for the leg, he's off-balanced a lot. His body's turning towards the left, and when he moves to correct his posture, Kashiwazaki whips him in the other direction for one of the most spectacular Yoko Tomoanages of all time. Check my Hamada Shori guard video for Hamada Shori's use of Tomoanages in Judo. But now I want to talk about leg grabs. When Hamada Shori competed in Sambo, she had to deal with leg grabs, and she dealt with them well. So we've seen these are the first two attempts in this World Championship final. This time the opponent goes for a teguruma, but Hamada counters with uchimata. I'm going to need to use slow-mo for this one because there's a lot happening in this teguruma to uranage attempt by the Bulgarian sambista. So first the Bulgarian moves in looking for the teguruma. Hamada retracts her leg and swings it across, looking perhaps for an osotogari. The opponent then switches to an uranage, but Hamada switches her legs and hooks over her opponent's knee. So here we have the lift, uranage. Hamada switches her legs, hooks over the opponent's leg. The Bulgarian tries an osotogari, but Hamada is able to remove her leg and push her opponent down to the mat, ending up in a newaza situation, which of course strongly favors Hamada Shori. Now the next one we will look at is kanibasami. In 1985, for women in Japanese judo, the kanibasami became an illegal technique, but it wasn't made illegal in international judo until the 1990s, so it was considered a weakness of Japanese women at the time, and it was used to score a point in this sambo match against Hamada Shori. But notice how quickly she was able to move into a newaza situation. So I'm going to finish the video with showing the full clip of the sequence we saw in slow motion at the very start of this video. This is Hamada Shori. She's using that belt control tate-shiho gatame pin on Izumi of Japan. Izumi will be one of the ladies that'll be looking to stop Hamada from having another run at the Olympics. Izumi is 6 years younger than Hamada. Time may be on her side. This is the one we began the video with. So this is the very beginning of the match. There's a few of these sequences are. Hamada's so good at finishing quickly. Little uchimata to chop down, and a rare slip here in missing the belt grip, but she was able to scramble, get a belt grip, turn her opponent and pin. Because it's right at the beginning of the match, her opponent has a lot of energy. She's willing to put up a fight to get out of this pin. But as I said earlier, there's no way out. So I hope you enjoyed this one. If you want to see more non-stop Newaza, more Hamada Shori, you can subscribe.